Son.
We are in the presence of God. Don't disturb me.
Lord, we
are not going to disturb you. If I cry, leave me alone. If I laugh, leave me alone. Because I want to enjoy the presence of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We had a wonderful crossover service. And we had a word from
God.
From Job 22:28. God says, declare a thing, and it will be established for you. So the light will shine on your ways. Many people are walking in darkness because they are quiet. But if you want to walk in the light, that scripture says, declare a thing, it shall be established, and your ways will shine. Many people keep quiet, and they suffer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Begin to talk. Now tell your neighbor, say neighbor, that mouth is not only for purple things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's to declare things. God is waiting for you to decree things so that he can establish them. Now, as the church, corporately we have declared that for us, 2020 is the year of open heaven. And then I explained what open heaven means. As it means the year of favor with God and favor with
man.
And then I had scriptures that we were reading. Number two, we said the year of open heaven for us means a year of clear vision. The things that God wants you to do, they will be very clear. Tell your neighbor, say no confusion. Clarity. Hallelujah. Ezekiel 1:1 says, now it came to pass in the 30th year, in the 4th month, and the 15th day of the month, as I was among the captives by the river Chiba, that the heavens were open, and I saw visions of God. Your eyes will be open. You will be able to see what God wants you to do. Church. Things will be very clear to us. Don't have confusion which business to take.
Amen.
Then we said the year of open heaven for us means the greater outpouring of the Holy Spirit. We are going to experience greater manifestations of God's Spirit. Signs, wonders, and miracles. Therefore, don't be afraid to pray for people. If God be for us, who can be against us? We walk with the greater
air.
The heavens are open before us. When the enemy comes like a flood, the Lord raises a standard. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall fear no evil. He leads me to green pastures. He leads me to by still waters. My cup is not only full, but it overflows. It means I'm not going only to be blessed. I'm going to be a blessing to
others.
Because the heavens are open. When the heavens are open, the anointing of God flows easily. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now we set the open heaven for us. It means the manifestations of angels. We all have angels. But most of the time they don't manifest that we can see them. You are going to see them. If you hear me say, you are going to see angels. We are going to see them manifest in this church. Because the Bible says they are ministering spirits to minister for us. It means they are like ushers to us. They do stuff for us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you speak in tongues, you are speaking the language of angels. You are also motivating and empowering yourself. You are also speaking mysteries with God. Now, as you speak in tongues, angels are activated. They begin to do stuff for you. My God, you don't hear me.
How do
you? If you hear me, shout like thunder.
How do
you? I tell you, there are spare parts in heaven. When there's a part in your body that is sick, they will replace that part. If you agree and you believe, shout amen. Hallelujah. If your blood is sick, they will drain that blood and give you new blood. Your kidneys are sick, they will remove those kidneys and give you new blood. My God, you don't hear what I'm saying. We walk with the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. And he even gave us power. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, powerful, full of the Holy Ghost. Open heaven for us means greater revelation. When you study the Bible, when you read the Word of God, no more confusion. It will be clear to you. God will show you deep things that are hidden in His Word. Yours is just to pull that body and sit him on the chair and tell him you read this book, and God will open your mind. You will have a greater understanding. Even when you speak, people will want to listen, because from you will flow rivers of living water. Rivers are flowing from your mind. People want to be around you. People want to sit where you are sitting. Because they know that the anointing is transferred. They know when you stand up and they rush and sit where you are sitting. Then they receive their miracles. Others will just come to shake your hand. Because they know there are rivers flowing there. There's power flowing there. There's power flowing there. You don't hear me. Come on, you must preach with me this morning. There's power flowing there. There's anointing flowing there. Wherever you go, you are the carrier of the glory of God. When you enter a place, darkness must go. Light must come.
Amen.
Because you are the light of the world. And you are carrying the light. Because Jesus says, my words to you are life and they are light. When you are carrying the word of God, you are carrying the light of God. Therefore, no darkness. If there are people that are not saved in your home, just visit them.
By telephone.
Visit them.
By telephone.
Sit there.
No more.
And let the conviction hit them.
You
will hear them say, what can I do to be saved? Because the heavens are open above us. Amen.
Amen.
Say amen like you believe it.
Amen.
Number open heavens for us. It's greater blessings. Now, as you give, as you bring your offering, as you bring your tithes, God says, test me and see if I want to open the heavens. God has opened heavens above your finances. You will not borrow, but you will lend people. If you hear me say amen, if you hear me say
amen,
it's a year of greater favor.
And
we know that favor is very unfair. Favor is very unfair. Favor is unfair. You get things that you do not deserve to get them. You'll be in a queue and they will call you from the deck and put you at the
front.
Because you are favored with God and favored with man. A man will be standing at the door of the bank to close. But when you come, he will open and say, come. Because you are favored, you'll be amazed how your applications won't be closed outside. They will wait until your application comes out. And because the angels are activated, they will make sure that it's pulled from the bottom and it is put on the top. Your haters will recommend you. Because you are favored with God, not favored with man. You will hear people saying, I don't know why I'm doing this. But I want us to promote this woman. I want us to promote this man. And then somebody will say, but the policies of our company do not allow. And then they will say, call the board meeting to change that clause. So that this person can be promoted. If you hear me, those that want to transfer and go back home, or want to go and work somewhere, they will enhance you. You don't hear me, they will enhance you. You won't even run after them. They will beg you to come. Hallelujah. And you will say to them, you know my salary, make sure that it is double when I come. You act as if you don't want to go there, so that they increase your salary. If you hear me shout like thunder, the heavens are open.
Yes.
Healing should be just bread for us. If you hear me, and say, I'm highly favored. In fact, I think we must change the way we greet. What do we say, how are you?
How are you unfair?
You must say, I'm highly favored. You decree it until it comes to pass. When you send a message, at the end, you write, I'm highly favored. And my name is so and so. Favor is very unfair. It makes you to have a baby without a womb. Yesterday, I had a meeting with the pastors. I had a powerful testimony. Pastor Gehoma Fete had a tumor in her brain like a tennis ball.
Pastor Gehoma Fete had a tumor in her brain like a tennis ball.
She did a scan and they said, hey, you must do an operation now.
We just did a scan, but
she said, I refuse by fire, by force.
We
like your
heart.
Yes.
The devil is a liar.
Yeah.
After a week, she went for another scanner. The second doctor said, I don't see anything except a shadow, as small as a bean.
Like one of the things.
just a shadow. It's fading away.
It's
a miracle. Within 7 days, that cancer that was as big as a tennis ball flashed away from his system. Hallelujah. Now say to yourself, this year, no sickness is allowed in my body. No sickness is allowed in my house. My children are highly favored. My partner is highly favored. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now I want to give you 10 points about favor. This I found from the scriptures. I discovered them from the word of God. These are points that will change your life. Now, number one, favor produces supernatural increase and promotion. You get promoted even if you don't qualify.
They will promote you without giving qualification. Those papers, they will salute to you.
Not because somebody will saying,
not because we had that particular battle or somebody did something else.
Because God wanted you to be there. He places you there. If you are not born again, you won't understand. You will think this is not possible. I tell you, it is possible. Before I became a deputy principal, there was this teacher who hated me by Kurka Pashin.
No, I'm going to tell you one toilet at a time.
But when there were interviews, he was in the panel.
Hallelujah.
And then the panel wanted to knock me. They wanted to give another one the post.
But they wanted to form a way post.
That person said, over my dead body.
Wow. Or is who?
The points are saying this man is the one who are going to be appointed. He is the first one he qualifies. I'm talking about a person who hated me with a great passion. And if you don't stop this thing you are saying now, I'm going to tell all the teachers what you are doing. And then the board had to sign. And then they had to appoint me as a deputy. He's saying you will be favored with men and women. And favor will cause you to be promoted. Favor will cause you to have increase. When you read Genesis 39, verse 21,
Genesis 39, 21 to 23.
But the Lord was with Joseph. And showed him mercy. And he gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. And the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hands all the prisoners who were in prison. Whatever they did there, it was his doing. The keeper of the prison did not look into anything that was under Joseph's authority. Because the Lord was with Joseph, and whatever he did, the Lord made him prosper. God will make you to prosper even in a place where you are a prisoner. Joseph was a prisoner. And the guards of the inmates, what do we call them? The prison warder said to Joseph, you are now in charge.
wena ya le go ntsha go le
thogometse. How do you make a prisoner to be in charge of other prisoners?
Wena ya mo thogometse la thogomele go le go ba.
Are you not afraid that they will scheme and plot and live and dodge and run away? Because Joseph was favored with God. And favored with men. Listen to that scripture. It says everything that he gave under the authority of Joseph, he did not check. Because Joseph was favored. I decree and I declare that you shall be favored. Even in places where they don't want you. Hallelujah. You will be favored. The bank is saying, you have been paying for the house for too long. Your house is now paid up. Because you are favored. There is power in favor. Power to change circumstances. Power to change even the atmosphere. People will meet in their boardrooms to talk about you. For your better. If you hear me shout like thunder, this is the year of open heaven. We are highly favored. I'm highly favored. I want you just to clap somebody's hand, three of them, and say, I'm highly favored. I'm highly favored. I'm highly favored. I'm highly favored. When the favor comes, nobody can stand before me. When I enter, they bow before me. Because I'm highly favored. And whatever you say, it goes.
So see what's that?
Hallelujah. Amen. Favor produces supernatural increase. And supernatural promotion.
Promotion.
Number two, favor produces restoration of everything that the enemy has stolen. If the devil has stolen from you, he must pay seven times. In fact, even your enemies will come to you in one way, but they will run away from you in seven different ways. Because of the glory that will be upon you. Because of the power and the anointing that will be upon you. Because of the favor of God upon your life. Restoration is your portion. I decree and I declare that everything that Satan has stolen will come back to you seven times. Those that hate you will see you growing higher. Going higher. Going higher. Going higher. Those that thought that you are dying, they are going to be shocked this year. They will see you becoming greater and greater and greater. Because the favor of God is upon you. I'm highly favored. Give somebody a high five to say, I'm highly favored. Hallelujah. favor brings restoration. Exodus 3 verse 21 says, and I will give these people favor in the sight of Egyptians. And it shall be when you go, that you shall not go empty handed. Egyptians were, Israelites were captured in Egypt. On the last day, when they were about to leave Egypt, under the leadership of Moses, they were so highly favored that God said to them, go to your neighbors, tell them to give you gold, tell them to give you silver, tell them to give you clothes, tell them to give you whatever thing you need. And the Bible says they plundered Egypt that night because God wanted them to leave loaded. Hallelujah. Yeah. Because they were being abused for 400 years. And God said, it's payback time. Favor brings payback. Favor brings payback. Favor brings payback. It's payback time.
Egypt.
In the sight of Pharaoh 7, in the sight of the people. Moses was sent to go and release and liberate the Jews. But the scripture we just read says he was honored by Pharaoh and all the people of Egypt. Hallelujah. Today I decree and I declare that you shall be honored wherever you go. Even at your home, they will not continue the meeting until you
arrive.
Even if you are the last born, they will say, we are waiting for her. We are waiting for him. You are the one who must say the final word. Because you are honored. You are highly favored. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I'm highly favored. By people and by God. Number four, favor produces increased assets. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy 33 verse 23 says, and of Naphtali he said,
Oh Naphtali,
satisfied with favor.
And
full of the blessing of the Lord, possess the west and the south.
The west and the south.
Joshua is blessing the Israelites.
Joshua is blessing the Israelites.
Now he looks at the tribe of this young man.
He
says, you are highly favored. When Arofofam Pichana like others,
you're not gonna give you small like others.
You will possess what? The whole of west and the whole of south. I decree and I declare
this
that you shall have increase in your assets. Hallelujah. They will ask you, why are you buying the bed house? Tell them it's just for show off. I want to show you that my God is in the Ibrahim.
Yes, yes, yes.
You can change the unchangeable. You can move the unmovable. Those that said he will remain in his father's house forever, he will come and rent from you. Because you are highly favored. Hallelujah. Number five. Favor produces great victories. In the midst of great impossibilities. Look at Joshua number 11 verse 18.
Joshua
made war a long time with all those kings. There was not a city that made peace with the children of Israel. Except the Hivites.
What did the Hivites?
The inhabitants of Gibeon. All the others they took in battle. For it was of the Lord to harden their hearts, that they should come against Israel in battle, that he might utterly destroy them, and that they might receive no mercy, but that he might destroy them as the Lord had commanded Moses. That scripture says, God will harden other people's hearts so that he can use you to show off his power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He will cause them to be heart so that you can walk before them with power and authority. Hallelujah. Because favor produces great victories. They will not believe in you. The more they doubt you, the more God shows off. The more God causes you to walk before
them.
Hallelujah. I'm an hallelujah. If you hear me shout like thunder. The more they say this one, look at him. Look at him.
Because
hallelujah. Hallelujah. In that house.
Looking down at you.
When you meet them on the way, they will start throwing away their crutches.
But that's the way
just
fell
with
people. Just by you passing
by. We are down the street, we take us to Patrosa.
Going down the street, going to buy your God.
Son Kamorelen.
That's showing off.
You know how Son Kamorelen is not, it does not mean you are proud that you
show me more than the Lord doesn't mean that
it means you know who you are.
Just by what you know.
Even when you walk like you know who you are. Those cats are my guy who people. Don't walk like a chicken. Walk like you know you are.
Yes.
They actually did stay that day.
Even if you're the money that day,
speak like you have it now.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Ask them how much is this car.
But what do I
give me the key. I want my bum on this city. You take the key and you sit there. Because you know that you walk with the great I am. He's in the department of abilities. We can change. We can turn things around. Look at your neighbor, say my things are turning. I'm highly favored. Come on. Come. When they put traps for
you. Why when they put traps for you?
The trap is a little smaller for
you. Those traps you trust
me. Because you walk with God. How
quick
are they? Amen. How quick are they? Amen.
Amen.
Stand up and shout, Jesus! In the eyes of other people, you are very far. Now listen to 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 22. Then Saul sent to Jesse.
Saul abela go Jesse.
Please let David stand before me. For he has found favor in my sight. Look at David. David was very young. Somewhere in the bush. Taking care of his father's sheep. There were other big guys in his family. I tell you, even the day Samuel came to anoint
David,
he was not at home. He was somewhere in the bush with the sheep. Someone said, Jesse, bring me all your children.
She lined them up.
And someone said,
Samuel, look at your name and say,
Someone said,
Samuel,
he looked at the firstborn. The second born.
There
were seven these boys.
Someone
said,
Jesse,
do you think all your kids are here? And then Jesse said, there's
in the bush.
He's taking care of the sheep. And someone said, I'm waiting, bring him. I want him here. When David entered, someone said, here comes the king. You will receive recognition even in the eyes of those that do not recognize you. And someone put oil on him. He said, you are now the king. Hallelujah. Even Saul wanted somebody to come and play for him.
There
were great musicians.
There
were big guys that were known.
The whole of worship team now.
Hallelujah. Amen. But Saul are like an old.
Hey.
But Saul said, I want that one.
Because when that one plays the harp, the demon leaves the
king.
Hallelujah. You shall be favored wherever you go. You will be recognized wherever you go. If you hear me shout hallelujah, look at number 7. Favor produces prominence.
Favor is a prominent
and preferential treatment. When you read the book of
Esther,
and I recommend that you read the whole book of Esther. Esther chapter 2, verse 17. The king loved Esther more than all the other women. And she obtained grace and favor in his sight more than all the virgins. So he set the royal crown upon her and made her queen instead of Vashti. You will run with others, but you will be the winner. You will apply with others, you will be the one appointed. The king said, Hadash, you are better than Vashti. Esther, you are better than Vashti. And Vashti pila ki ena queen.
Vashti was the real queen.
Mara hola ki wa man?
But Esther was called.
You will be treated and preferred. but they will treat us smart as if you are the person.
They will treat you smart like if you got a queen, move.
They will pull you from the back barrier and you come here.
But that will have to go where I want to go.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All the things I'm saying, I'm reading from the way. The mind
right.
Yours is just to decree them and declare them.
Yeah.
Bible says your tongue is powerful.
Yeah.
Your mouth is powerful.
Yeah.
It can produce life.
It
can produce death. Don't look at the symptoms. Forget about symptoms. Hallelujah. Forget about symptoms. Symptoms is a way of the enemy to cause fear.
Symptoms,
and when you fear, he has the power to enter. Now you must say, I will fear no evil.
Yeah.
For I walk with the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd. I will fear no man.
Let's have a move.
I will fear no demon.
Let's have a demon.
I will fear no devil.
Let's have a Satan.
I will fear no supervisor.
Let's have a supervisor.
Oh, I will fear no president.
Let's have a president.
I will fear no minister.
Let's have a minister.
I walk with the King of Kings.
Yes.
You are highly favored.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Now, favor number 8. Favor produces petitions granted.
Favor.
Even by ungodly civil authorities. There was this funny guy called
Haman.
He wanted to kill all the Jews. He made very tall guillotines with the intention of hanging all the Jews there. But immediately Esther was appointed to be the queen. And then Esther said to the king, my petition and my request is this. If I have found favor in the sight of the king, and if it pleases the king to grant my petition and fulfill my request, then let the king and Haman come to the banquet, which I will prepare for them. And tomorrow I will do as the king has said. I'm reading from Esther chapter 5 verse 7. Oh, the king is the one who's supposed to call people to the banquet. But Esther is the one who's calling the king to the banquet. Even the man Haman wanted to kill the Jews. He said, tomorrow come to the banquet. Then I will tell you my request.
Don't be in the hurry to say your request.
You also in Kemore name.
Yes.
I mean the evil.
Yes.
Also in Kemore name.
Yes.
Or no, I'll tell you tomorrow.
Yes.
You missed this one. Guys, I'll tell you tomorrow.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Also, in Cameroon, it does not mean you are proud.
It
just means you know who you are.
I'm
fearfully and wonderfully made.
That's who?
In the image of the Most High God.
Something more.
And Jesus gave me the authority.
Yes,
therefore, I'm in charge.
Yeah.
And when they arrive at the banquet, remember, Haman is the right-hand man of the king. Now, Esther says to the king, this man wants to kill the Jews. And he has already built the guillotine. And without any waste of time, the king said, Haman, go hang away in the morning.
The king said, heaven, you're going to hang me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, this year, Your petitions will be heard.
Your
petitions will be heard. Your requests will be answered. Those that want to hang you, they will hang in your place. Those that dig graves for you, they are the ones to enter the graves. Because you are highly faithful. Number 9, favor causes policies, the rules and the regulations, and laws to be changed, and
the
reverse to your advantage. Esther chapter 8 verse 5.
Chapter 8 verse 5, yeah.
If it pleases the king, and if I have found favor in his
sight,
and things seems right to the king,
and
I'm pleasing in his eyes, let it be written to revoke the letters that were written by Haman. Remember,
Haman
was the right hand man of God.
He
will just write letters and say, king sign, and the king will sign.
Can't
you sign it? All the Jews should die.
Not knowing that the king has said that all the Jews must die.
When Esther was a queen, he told the king the plan of
Haman.
Now, after Haman was hanged, the queen says, now that letter is still intact. Write, king, write another letter to revoke. Cancel that letter of Haman.
Cancel
that
letter of Haman.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now I decree and I declare that policies will be changed on your
favor.
Rules will be changed. Regulations will be changed.
Laws
will be changed. It will be just for you. Because you are highly favored.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, say I'm highly favored. Today don't worry when I'm always saying I'm highly favored. Talk to your neighbor, say neighbor from today. When I always say I'm highly favored. Because it's a fact I'm highly favored. And I'm activating my faith. You are not talking, say I'm
activating my faith.
Hallelujah. You will hear people say, you must pass by my house. I have something for you.
Can I sing with
please pass by my house. I went to Joburg.
I went to Joburg.
Kabona this boutique.
And I saw this boutique.
Kabona this thing,
I saw this thing that I think it's suiting.
When I scratch a house, you know what?
Don't be in your house.
Oh, you know, I see you tomorrow.
That's it, Kabona.
But
what
you know, produces battles won, which you won't even fight. Number 10, favor will cause you to win battles that you won't need to fight. Listen to Psalm 44 verse 3.
Psalm 44 verse 3, yeah.
It says, for they did not gain possession of the land by their own sword. Nor did their own arm save them. But it was your right hand, your arm, and the light of your countenance, because you favored them. There will be battles forged against you. But because you are more than conquerors, because you are highly favored, you won't need to fight those battles. The Lord will fight for you. The captain of hosts will fight for you. Hallelujah. I hear somebody saying, but 2019 was bad for me. Listen, draw a line.
Hey.
And say, and say
"2019,
we are gone with your thing." This is 2020.
Hey.
I'm highly favored. Maybe you are saying, "I did not do well in 2019. I decree and I declare that this year you will do your best. And God will be seen in your weakness. God will be seen in your weakness. When you think you are down, the power of God will manifest. And you will walk in glory. Come on, let's all stand. I want us to really talk to God and decree and declare the points that we shared this morning. You say it from the bottom of your heart that you are favored. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. When the enemy comes like a flood, the Lord shall raise a standard. You will see things falling on your right and on your left, but nothing will come next to you. Those incurable diseases, they will not come to your house. You don't hear me? Those sicknesses, but are incurable, they will not come to your house. Because you are favored. Because you are favored. No one will fire you from your work. No one will fire you from your work. No one will fire you from your work. Because you are favored. Because you are favored. Favored. In the eyes of God. And in the eyes of men. People will gather in your name. To talk about you, for your better, because you are favored. You will hear people saying that you must get a miracle.
You will hear people saying today you must come to
hell.
We think you are tired.
Just rest today.
They
don't know that it's a setup.
How are you going to be set up?
That God did not want you to go to work. Because when they arrive at work, probably the incidents which nobody can explain, how God wanted you to remove you from those things. Ah, you don't hear me. You don't hear me. Are you listening? Shout like thunder. Coming, you.